We're going to ask Reverend Andrew Jackson to start us in prayer.
Let us pray. Father God, we come today. We come, Heavenly Father, realizing that it is your hand of providence that has allowed our city, our parish, to prosper. Father, we thank you for this great day. We thank you for all that you've done, all that you're doing, and all that you will do. Father, we ask that you would look upon the governor. We ask that you would look upon the lieutenant governor. Father, look upon this parish president, the mayor, and all of those, Heavenly Father, that are assembled here on today. For we know, except you be of the house, we labor in vain. Heavenly Father, we thank you right now. We thank you for all that you've done, all that you're going to do. We thank you for Medline, that is going to be a lifeline for this community. Father, thank you right now. It is in the name of your Son that we pray on this day. And all of God's people said, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, sir. That was beautiful. You can all be seated if you have a seat. And we're going to go right into some remarks by leadership. But first, I want to make sure that I welcome all of you here. The governor, lieutenant governor, Secretary Pearson, mayor. There's way too many elected officials and dignitaries here to list everyone, but we have parish council members here. We have state representatives, state senators. We have Hammond City here and many, many great friends and leaders in our community. And we know that this is a big day and we appreciate you being here. With that being said, we'll move on to Mayor Pete Penapinto for comments from the city.
Thank you, Robbie. It is a blessing for the city of Hammond to be standing here today. This could not have been possible without our council members. I'd like to recognize Carly Gonzalez. Thank you, Carly. Steve Leon, thank you. And Sam DeVittoria, thank you. Without you all, this not would have happened. The hard work by Parish President Robbie, Ginger Canzalosi, and their team to bring Medline here. When we first met Bill with Medline and his team, I've been meeting with Dimitri since day one. And one of the things that was impressive to me was Bill, when he mentioned, first thing he said was, what are the challenges here? I want to know. And where is Bill? And I want to thank you for that, Bill, because we went directly into the things that we thought we would have obstacles to deal with. And I want to say we dealt with each and every one of them. And thank you, Medline, for that. Your team as well. Big Bob Murray with his team, who's going to oversee this site. Bob, thank you. Sylvia Bush Options, thanks you for sure for your donation to help support them. And then also Bobby Dorr with 3 LLC, who's handling all this dirt work and the trees and what have you. Bobby, thank you. He knows, we talked about how passionate I was about the after-school program, and Bobby helped us out with that as well. So what a wonderful team we're dealing with here with Medline. Community involved before they even start. We haven't even broke ground. And yet here we are acting as if we've known each other for years and just great partners to our community. So I don't want to be too long. I just want to say thank you to all that are here. Thank you to everyone that's made this possible. And thank you, Governor, for being here as well, sir.
Thank you, Pete. Now we're going to have Lieutenant Governor Billy Nungesser. We really appreciate you being here, Governor, Lieutenant Governor. And we're going to hear from his thoughts about this.
Thank you, Mr. President, Governor, and to all the elected officials that work so hard on this project, congratulations. I want to tell you, in charge of tourism, as we work to rebuild the tourism industry, the business traveler is so important as we try to attract the direct flights back to New Orleans. And surely this company and the people they bring in here will absolutely help us do that. So it's a great day for Louisiana. Don, thank you for all your hard work, and a great day for this parish. Thank you.
And now we'll hear from Pete mentioned Mr. Bill Abington from Medline. Bill is the Executive Vice President of Global Operations. He is probably the guy who made the final decision to move to this location. We want to thank him very much for that. And with that being said, I'll bring Bill up so we can hear about Medline's future in Tangipahoa Parish.
Good afternoon.
I want to start by welcoming all the state and local officials. Appreciate you attending and very much appreciate all your support. There are far too many to mention and far too many names, but several really stand out that helped bring Medline to Hammond. Governor John Bel Edwards, Parish President Robbie Miller, and Hammond Mayor Pete Patino. And I have to thank the Economic Development Council. There are lots of involved, but they were with us the whole way. I mean, every time we had a question, they were here supporting, walking us through the process. We have 9 million square foot distribution centers going on around the country right now, and nowhere have we seen more assistance, more help, more cooperation to help make sure we're following the procedures and doing what we need to do. So thank you very much to those groups. When I think about how we got here, I think about a great partnership between state and local officials, but also industry. We're working together on a project that not only balances economic development, but is support for Louisiana healthcare and the needs of this community. Medline has been a part of the North Shore for 20 years, and we're very proud of that. It's something we don't take lightly, and we know we would not be here without broad support. I'd also like to recognize our amazing Louisiana team members. These team members have been here day in and day out through the pandemic, as well as helping respond for the last 20 years with numerous disasters that have occurred in this region, to make sure we're here to help support the frontline healthcare workers and the healthcare systems that protect all of us. In many ways, this groundbreaking is a testament to our team members, again, who are working day in and day out through this pandemic and through other natural disasters to make sure that we're here to help the community. In addition to supporting healthcare, I would like to share some other things that we want to do for the state and local community. There are a number of things that we're working on. First, we really want to continue to grow our business to be able to hire 450 team members that'll run our distribution center. We also plan to add about 350 construction jobs during this process. We want to focus on qualifying local vendors where we can to help protect and support our home for many decades to come. And we want to be a responsible taxpayer for the state, parish, and local community. And finally, we want to continue to be a good community partner. And we've seen that with everyone we've met, has just rolled out the red carpet to really say, how can we help? And it's been open, honest dialogue communication so that we're all working together in an expeditious manner to make sure this investment occurs. We want to hire locally, we're going to support community organizations, and our team members are going to volunteer. I look forward to speaking to anyone else that has questions. We're blessed to be here. We sincerely thank all of you, and we hope you'll all come back in about 12 months when we have our groundbreaking, when we open the doors. Thank you.
Thank you, Bill. And we are very pleased to have you here. At this time, we're going to hear from our one and only Tangerville Parish resident, the sheriff's brother. That's how most of us know him. Some of us know him as the governor, but he's our good friend, and we're thrilled that he is our governor today. And I know that he's anxious to let us know how he feels about Medline. And with that, I'll turn it over to Governor John Bel Edwards.
Thank you, Robbie. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Mr. President. And I'll tell you, I ran for governor because Daniel was already sheriff and that job was taken. I want to thank all of you for coming out today and for giving me an opportunity to do something, although it's related to COVID in some way. It's more of a celebration, and we're talking about things that are happening in Louisiana, even as we move through this pandemic and all the challenges that it has presented. And I appreciate all of y'all for coming out here. Reverend Jackson, we appreciate your prayer very much. And we want to thank the Lieutenant Governor for being here. And I will tell you, Billy's working extremely hard all across the state of Louisiana and has been a tremendous partner to me throughout this pandemic in particular. And Billy, I want to thank you for that. I want to thank the mayor for his leadership, for helping to make this possible, obviously the parish president as well, And Bill, thank you so much for being here to represent Medline at this ceremony. I know we've got a lot of elected officials. I am going to recognize Daniel. Where's my baby brother? Thank you very much for being here, Daniel. I think I saw Mr. Perilou, my DA, when I was coming up. Scott, good to see you. And Beth Mizell, I think Senator Mizell came in a few minutes ago. Thank you very much, Senator, for being here. And being bald-headed, I just assume that cloud stay right where it is right now. And I know there are a lot of elected officials that I didn't call by name. Please know that I appreciate each and every one of you. If there's anybody who knows how hard it is to be an elected public official right now, it's me. And it's hard. It's never been more difficult, and I appreciate all of you for making yourself available for that service. You know, this project has actually been in the making for many years. Today we're seeing the plans take shape as a major new investment for Hammond and Tangipahoa Parish, really for the surrounding area. The truth is, we wouldn't be here today but for the determined collaboration and the partnerships that were formed in order to bring this project to life. And really, it was leadership more than anything else that brought Medline here to Hammond. Leadership and vision, that's what was required to find a new home for an extraordinary economic development project. I think some of these figures were already mentioned. 450 new full-time direct jobs on this site, along with 350 temporary construction jobs at the outset to build this 650,000 square foot medical distribution facility. Probably had this site been built and been operational at this time last year, I'd be sending National Guardsmen to commandeer everything that you had. But it is important that we have expanded capacity in state and in the country for the essential items that will be passing through this warehouse. Through this project, LED estimates that another 611 indirect jobs will result, making the full impact of this project, this site, be more than 1,000 new jobs in the coming years. And I want to stop and thank all the folks at LED, and I'm gonna mention some other folks, but Luzon Economic Development has never stopped working. It's never been more challenging because of COVID, but Louisiana has tremendous advantages over many other states. But one of those is the team that we have working to pursue economic development projects, investment, job creation here in Louisiana. And Don and his team do a great job. And in fact, it was just announced that Louisiana is in the top 10 states across the country in Site Selection Magazine. And I think they call it the Governor's Cup. So anytime they're going to call it the Governor's Cup, it's good that we're placing. But that's currently in this particular challenging time that we're in. We've been able to land economic development projects like the one here at Medline. And we announced one not long ago, the total investment. Grown fuels in Baton Rouge, $9.2 billion. So we've been working extremely hard. We've got a good team who's doing this, and I told you it takes teamwork. So Medline, along with Luzon Economic Development, the Tangipahoa Parish government, leadership there, the city of Hammond, the staff in my office have worked extremely hard. Communities win, people win, when their leadership comes together to accomplish major goals. That's what happened here today. That's why we're here for this announcement. So I congratulate and I thank Medline for its continued commitment to our state. You know, at its current distribution site on the North Shore, Medline has actually operated for almost two decades. But this renewed investment of $45 million will enable tremendous growth in medical distribution for for generations to come. So I want to thank Bill Abington again, Dimitri Ducon again with Medline, the entire team. Thank you, Robbie Miller, the Tangipahoa Parish President, Mayor Panapinto for making this project possible. And again, thank you, Billy. So many others as well. You all are aware that the COVID-19 pandemic has taken a toll on our nation, really our world, our nation, our state, everybody. Today is the one-year anniversary of the first COVID confirmed case in our state. We've come a long way. Sunday will be the one-year anniversary of the first death from COVID in Louisiana. And by the way, I've issued a proclamation today so that Sunday, March the 14th, will be a day of prayer and remembrance across the state of Louisiana. And why is that important? Because 9,758 of our fellow Louisianans, our brothers and sisters, have died from this disease. And for people who thought that it wasn't a big deal, the deaths in Louisiana in 2020 were 30% higher than they were in 2019. And for those who thought it's no more than the flu, actually 15 times as many people died from COVID over the last year than have died from some of our worst flu seasons. We've lost too many lives. And we still have some work to do, by the way. I'm encouraging everybody to get vaccinated as soon as you are eligible to do that, because that's the only way we put this pandemic behind us, is enough people have to be vaccinated. We have to have that herd immunity to get through this. And between now and then, we still have to slow the transmission, especially because of the variants that are out there that are growing in prevalence, especially the UK variant. You know, I just got off the phone. One of the reasons when we pulled up, I didn't get off the out of the car immediately, is I was on a call with all 50 governors in the White House going through all the data, the most recent. And I will tell you, while we're doing much better, and we have lots of reasons to be hopeful, we've got some work left to do. And I know a lot of you are sports fans like me. And the best analogy I can think of is from the time you start playing baseball, your coach tells you, or softball, whatever, your coach tells you, run through the base. You got to get to the base before the ball does. And so we have to run through this process over the next several weeks, or however long it takes, to slow the transmission and speed the vaccination. Please know that all three vaccines are safe. They are effective, and you should be vaccinated as soon as you are able. But one of the ways we slow the spread of this virus is through PPE. That's a large part of what Medline does. I will tell you, during the past year, there were 60 billion units of personal protective equipment that have been delivered across the United States of America. 60 billion items. And spending on PPE, is forecast to nearly triple by 2027, according to the Health Industry Distributors Association. So more than ever, we need the growth of medical supply chain companies like Medline. We need them here in Louisiana. We need them across the country. And Medline does it better and bigger than any other private family-owned business. It is a $10 billion per year business. Beyond the current public health emergency, Louisiana continues to see strong economic recovery as well. And sustaining that momentum ensures that we'll be stronger when this pandemic is behind us. And Medline is helping us in that regard too. So this 650,000 square foot facility that's going to take shape behind me will feature state-of-the-art operations, will be built to medical grade standards to ensure safe sanitary handling of products. And we are proud that this new facility would ultimately have Louisianans supporting this crucial step in the medical supply chain and getting much needed medical equipment to doctors and to patients in need. So as we break ground on this facility today, let's celebrate what it represents. Let's be resolved that there will be more investment, more job creation, more economic development here in Tangipahoa Parish and all across the state of Louisiana. And I can assure you that Don and I will be working nonstop for the remainder of this, my second term, in order to make that happen. And I intend to come back to Tangipahoa Parish, my home parish, as many times as possible to make more such announcements about economic development. So thank you again for the opportunity to be here, and welcome Medline. You will have a bright future in Hammond, America.
Now it's my turn for just a moment to do closing remarks. I'll finish my remarks. Father Robert Merced from Holy Ghost will say a benediction, and then we'll move over to the actual groundbreaking. Many of you know Tangipahoa Parish You know that move your family to a better place to live. Move your products throughout the world. Move your business, watch your profits soar. Tangible Parish, move here. Well, I think we have all of the meanings of move here that that slogan stands for. Medline, moving here. Probably some of their folks will move here. But it also talks about us, Tangible, as a whole, our state, to move whenever things need to happen. Our neighbors around here move to make sure that this project is going to be better than it was originally designed. That's going to be more fit the neighborhood better. It's going to be more caring about what's going on around them. The state moved, the governor's office, LED, DOTD, the parish, from our economic development, our parish council, then the city and the city council, the mayor. We all moved to make sure that this project came to Tangible Parish. And we had to do some convincing to make that happen. But I think the biggest thing was that move here, the idea that we all moved to work together to make it happen. It was the message that Medline needed to hear, they needed to see, and that's what sealed the deal. With that being said, I thank you so much for being here. Father Robert's going to come up and say a benediction, and then we're going to actually do the groundbreaking. Thank you again very much. Appreciate you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Well, Lord our God, we praise you for your gift of land and the ability to use it wisely. Grant that what we have undertaken this day be to the glory of your name, may it be successfully completed for the good of all your people. We place our plans for this building site in your hands, trusting that with your guidance, they will bear much fruit for the community. We thank Medline for being ambassadors to this community of faith, for the good that they will do for all those who live in Tangipahoa and the state of Louisiana. We make this prayer in your name, Jesus, our Lord and Savior, our King. In his name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Marriage is the sweetest gift. You truly become a team. Luke and I shared a vision for our community. We saw an opportunity to better it for our children and for yours. While losing Luke has been devastating, I know that two things can be true at the same time. A person can be full of grief while still having hope for the future. I want to pick up the torch and continue the journey to represent all people, working with anyone who can help deliver real results. I am Julia Letlow, and I approve this message.